like
Water.
If you talk to him,
you have any no, words
like,
with him?
Well, you know, he just won. So everybody trying to talk to him. So you know, it's hard for him to hear somebody. But everybody trying to.
Your radio.
Okay, one question for you, Randy. If you were managing Wilder, would you put him in straight away with Joshua, or would you wait a little bit longer? Should the fight happen this year or next year?
This year.
I think if Joshua win, and so I think they both can make about $250 million. So why not make the money while the money's there? Right. You know, so the whole thing is that I think, you know, and being a great fighter, you make money because you have proven to the people that you're the best at time there. So at some point in time, I don't know if Josh is gonna be there. I'm telling Parker, he's great. How come he's another fighter with a good mindset, and also those three fighters got the mindset. And those three fighters, the three youngest one too. Now, this guy was like a George Foreman. Because this guy 40 years old. I said, you this guy, the other guy 28. I'm telling you, so you kind of thought in a later round, the guy with the most experience is going to get it. And that's what I thought myself. I said, oh man, after the sixth round, he gonna get tagged. He did. But he persevered. He came through.
When you go through something like that, what does that do for your confidence?
Well, it builds it. It makes it even stronger. I'm like, you know, I remember when I beat George Foreman, I didn't think a person with two hands could beat me. It didn't make no difference how small and how big you were. But you know, the fact is I ran into both.
One last question for me. You were in Wembley, you saw Vladimir Klitschko fight Anthony Joshua, you've seen this as well. If I was to put them in later this year, who would win?
Well, you know, it's hard to tell because, you know, like, The two common things about Joshua and Wilder is they're both young, and so, you know, they both are recovered. And so, you know, it's more even than anything. And but for his confidence, I'm sure you have to get to. I'm saying the guy with the most confidence, I'm telling you, they get their hands off first. Somehow they figure things out. Cause confidence. Then when that's confident, there's no fear. So they take chances, whether they win or lose. And because they win or because they take chances,
Very well, a person
who don't take chance lose. And saying that's the difference when it comes out of confidence.
Hey, Jack, one question for Radio Ryan.
All right, so there you have it. We're here post-fight. That was the legend, Raul Marquez. Raul, what did you think of the Wilder fight?
Oh my God, it was a great fight, man. Great fight. I mean, everybody always likes to see heavyweights. Ortiz really surprised me, man. I didn't think he was gonna perform that well. I mean, but I think it has to do with his amateur background. Had a lot of amateur experience.
A lot of heart,
28-0, 24 knockouts. I thought he had Wilder, but Wilder knew how to come back and survive and just
get the knockout.
I mean, Ortiz had him, man. When you got power like Wilder, that changes everything. I had Ortiz winning the fight. I know the judges had, I don't care what the judges say.
Had Ortiz winning.
But Ortiz was winning the fight. I know Steve Parker had him winning. I think Paulie was talking about he had Ortiz winning. I had Ortiz winning by 3 points. I don't care what anybody says. Ortiz was winning the fight, but Wilder, you had a comeback. You know, when he got hurt, then he lost like two rounds. It seems like he was recuperating, trying to load up with that missile, man, that big right hand.
And it worked.
And then that big, you know, he looks wild. He is wild, but when you got power like that, the other opponent is hurt. That don't matter. You throw punches however you hurt the guy. You gotta have that killer instinct and go after him. And then that brutal uppercut, man, just paralyzed him. That was it. But hats off to Ortiz because he fought a hell of a fight.
He shocked us.
He shocked me. He shocked me too. He shocked a lot of people because I didn't expect that.
I said four rounds. That was way off.
I thought it was going to be like a stern fight.
Yeah.
I thought it was going to be quick, but he really surprised me, man. He really did. But man, that Wilder, man, that power, that when he, like I said, when he got that power and that strength, that changes everything. I don't care if you're winning. I don't care if you're losing all the fight. Only one shot, boom.
There you have it. Raul Marquez, former champion. Now we show them. What an exciting night of boxing. It was exciting.
Yeah, it was.
What did you think?
Right here, ask my man right here.
What did you think?
Tall, baby.
Congratulations on the win.
Thank you.
Very underrated trainer right there, baby. New guys.
We told everybody that was going to happen. We told you in Vegas, remember?
Yup. You even.
Told you in Vegas.
But talk to me really quick about Wilder fight. How crazy was that fight?
I didn't get to see it. My fighter just won the world title. I'm not going to sit there.
You guys fought a great fight. Thank you.
Congratulations, Kobe.
My fighter just won the world title, man.
Hit me up on Instagram.
Yeah, man.
Thank you. It was what a night of boxing. It was crazy. Here's Vander. We're gonna walk around. This is just mayhem. Everyone's so pumped up. The adrenaline is running through everyone's blood right now. Waiting to see who's walking by, who's getting stuff. This is just a beehive right now. What a night. What a night. What a great fight for boxing. Did you enjoy it?
Yes, sir.
My hands are full.
Congrats.
Thank you.
Congrats on the Ring Magazine.
We're live right now with the little audience. So, thank you. Thanks so much. So, let's see what's happening over here. I'm good. How's it going? How you good? I'm good. So, we're here backstage. Excuse me. Sorry. Excuse me. Zachary, what do you think of Wilder tonight?
Beautiful fight. That's what a heavyweight fight should be. Two heavyweights going at it. They both got hurt in the fight, tremendously hurt in the fight. And you know, Wilder showed he had heart, and he came back and finished the job. You know, you got to give it to Wilder, but also give it to Ortiz, too.
I always do, but good seeing you. Tell everyone where to follow you.
Follow me at Zach Richard on Instagram and Twitter. My next fight is March 24th.
Absolutely. Charlotte, how are you feeling right now?
Oh, yeah, John.
Hey, I'm super happy. I don't know what the hell I feel. I feel like I was in a bunch of anxiety and it's over with.
Did you watch the fight closely? Were you on the edge of your seat like all of us?
Absolutely. It was an awesome fight, one of the best fights Brooklyn put on. And I'm super excited about Dante Wilder and Ortiz. I hope they can do it again.
Again? What did you think of Wilder's chin, Wilder's balls, Wilder's heart?
Hey, both of those guys.
And Ortiz too.
Hey, not even being on no humble shit. Both of those guys show heart. You know, both of those guys did what they had to do. Both of those, I couldn't tell. Like, it was a hard fight. Like, you never know what to do. They heavyweights. Somebody gonna get smacked, somebody ain't.
When you were watching Wilder struggle, first he dropped Ortiz, do you think it was over? Or do you think, oh, he's gonna stop it?
Hell, man. But,
does it make you want to jump in the ring right now and have a fight?
Man, it was heavyweights, man. When I see somebody in my weight rumble,
Mark,
crazy.
You're hungry.
I'm excited about what happened tonight. It was dope. I love when fights like that happen. It makes it more entertaining for the sport.
Okay, Wilder, Joshua.
Don't give Wilder some problems if Joshua and Wilder look the way he did tonight. Only because, let me take that shit back. Wilder gonna give Joshua some problems. Just Wilder, learn him.
Bro. You look like come out with some awesome.
You ain't in the AMJ. Huh? You ain't in the AMJ.
I'm glad you weren't here when him and Jacob faced off.
You're not in the AMJ. It ain't about the money. What the fuck is about the pride and what you want to do? You want to fight me, we in the ends. Don't get it fucked up. I ain't gonna talk about money because it ain't about the money.
What you talking about?
Jacob was telling
shit.
Him that he ain't.
Man, I'm not in the AMJ. Oh, I know. That's cool. That's cool. Keep running your fucking mouth. You'll see me.
Wasn't Jacob the one that said
keep running your fucking mouth? Wait, what the hell? Like don't ask a messy question.
He got a new screen saving mouth on his phone. It's gonna be a new screen.
Join in here, ho. Ain't got nothing to do with it. Keep running your fucking mouth. Let's do it, bro. Right, let's get out of here, bro. Nigga worried about the money.
We talked before. Yeah, you told
me. He worried about the money. I'm worried about that issue.
That's it, guys. We're walking out. All right. That's it. Thank you.
Sam, right. What up?
Hey. Great. Hey, that's enough interviews for the day. That's it.
Thank you. What you got over
the fight?
That's vintage 90s heavyweight fight right there.
Oh, my God.
Man, this man just said he want to wait on Walt.
He want to wait on Walt. I'll come here and talk to him.
All right. How's it going?
Haley, you got it all on here?
Everything.
Which part?
They want to see Wilder. What do you think? Exciting fight?
I thought that was awesome.
Did you lose a heartbeat in there?
Awesome, Ellie. That's what that's boxing needs, of course. Something like that.
That was a great
the heavyweights
fight.
Right there at his best. You can't. Luis Ortiz has nothing to hold his head down about. Nothing, you know.
Okay.
Deontay, so obviously he faced adversity and overcame.
So if I'm Anthony Joshua and I watch this tonight, do I want to take the fight ASAP or do I want to wait 2-3 years?
Hey, well, I mean, you know, Anthony Joshua's ready. You know, I think he's ready. You know, he showed that he's ready on his side as well too. So I think he wants it as soon as he can. And I'm sure he might take another fight right now beforehand, but then it's his time.
You know, how's it going, Rock? I know Zach, that's a homie. Mark, congratulations, what a fight. Mark Freeland, 110-1 in amateurs, one of the coaches of Deontay Wilder, seconds after the fight. Mark, what did you tell me about the fight? We talked this morning, we talked this afternoon.
I loved it, Mark.
Tell me about what it was like being in the corner for Wilder.
Well, I mean, it was a good fight. It was a good fight, you know, in boxing. And when he got hit, you know, I was like, ooh, okay. And I think in the second, the next time, you know, the next round, I think I heard it. I told him, I said, run. Stay away from him. Don't get on the corner. Don't get on the rope. Just run. Throw out a jab. Throw out a jab. Just because if you jab, he's not doing nothing. He'll just sit there. I said, so just jab. Just to stay out the way. Just get your head clear. The next round, came back and stopped him the next round.
What do you think about his performance?
He can show that he can take a punch.
He has heart and balls.
Yeah, that he does.
Okay, if Anthony Joshua watches this, what do you think? Does he want to take the fight right now?
No,
2025?
30.
2030? Why doesn't he want to fight Wilder now? Too dangerous for him?
No, he's serious. Okay, this man can take a punch and he can punch.
It's true.
Coming out of that seventh round.
Right.
What, coming out of that seventh round, what was your instructions to Deontay Wilder?
I think I heard him. You know, I said, look, stay away from him. Don't use your jab. Don't get in the rope. Don't get in the corner. I said, because he's got to stop him in order to get to him. You can only get jab in the move and you can't touch him.
How are you going to celebrate this big win?
Go back to your hotel and go to sleep.
That's it. Back to work Monday.
Back to work. Back
were you worried when King Kong was landing those big shots and we didn't know if Deontay was going to...
I just looked. I was like... You know, I just kept looking. I'm like, okay. What is the thing of when, you know, I guess from boxing, from, you know, from all the years I've been boxing, it's like, okay. You know.
So, Mark, how does it feel? You're holding a belt right now?
No, there's nothing in there. I got
to
go.
Oh, you have to go get it. Oh, I thought you had the belt.
Got to go pick up something.
Well, congratulations. It was a great fight. One of the best ones I've seen ever.
It was a good fight. I mean, people were booing earlier because, you know, they're both trying to get away from each other. Nobody wanted to get hit, which is understandable. So, but it turned out the way some people wanted, some people didn't.
Well, congratulations again. It was a great fight, and you know.
Any changes made in camp now that he had after a round 7? Like, is there anything that you would like to change to prevent that from happening?
No. I mean, you know, the experience, yeah, that experience, you know, find yourself
Sam, what did you think of the fight tonight?
That was a great fight for both people, for everybody. Because Ortiz fought him back good. The champ did what he was supposed to do, got his win in. It was a great night. Great night for boxing.
And Denzel was here. What did he tell you?
Denzel loved it. Denzel was excited. Judge Mathis was excited. Denzel Washington just had a great time.
Everyone had a great. Danny Garcia, Danny Rosie Garcia, Perez.
All the fighters was here, the Charlo brothers.
No one knew that Wilder has a chin. No one knew that Wilder has such balls.
Wilder had a strength. Wilder did not go down. He took all them punches, and there was some real vicious punches.
And he came back.
Yeah.
And got the knockout.
Yeah.
Okay, Wilder Joshua, we talked this morning. What do you say now?
Now you can talk.
Okay.
After the fight, now you can.
All right.
Now
break
it's
it down.
On. Now it's on. And it won't take long either. It won't take as long as we think it's going to take. It's going to happen first of the year, next year, end of the year, first day. It's going to happen.
You think it's going to be on? You think that performance might have scared him away?
No, it didn't scare him because he didn't kill him, knock him down in the first two rounds.
That uppercut was pretty nasty.
He didn't do all that. He didn't do all that.
Why is security mad? Are they King Kong Ortiz fans?
Deontay coming. Sorry.
Champ's coming.
Champ is coming.
I don't see him. He's gonna be here sooner than later. But we're waiting for Deontay Wilder to walk by.
Guys, that's the team on the side.
We're here seconds after the Wilder. What did you think? You enjoyed it?
Elie, man, it's crazy.
It was a
great
crazy fight.
Yeah.
Great fight.
Coming out of our gym, man, it's been crazy.
Yep, he was at your gym. You saw him train before this.
Yeah, he shook the gym with those jabs.
Were you nervous during the fight?
I was nervous. My heart pounded in the seventh round. But
did you enjoy the fight, Badu Jack?
Please. Hell yeah.
I was on the edge of my seat. Were you too?
Yeah. Good fight.
What did you think about Wilder? Chin, balls, heart.
A little sloppy, but he took it and finished it. That took some real punches. They could have almost stopped it.
I thought they
came back. Came back and knocked him up.
Good thing he had a good ref in there. An amateur ref, a not experienced ref, would have stopped it, and we would have been in a different situation right now.
Yeah.
So what did you learn from the fight tonight? We're just watching.
What I learned?
Yeah, anything? Did you pick up anything?
Wilder can take it. We already know he can give it.
There you have it. Badu Jack, we should follow him at Badu Jack. Thanks, Badu. Right now, we have a little audience. So we're keeping it going. Let's see.
Character. He got balls. He's got balls.
Paulie, good thing there was an experienced ref in there and not a bad ref, because he would have stopped it. Yeah.